Hello and welcome to Time Series Forecasting. In this video, I'm going to keep talking about the concept of dummy variables that I introduced in my previous video, and I'm going to extend the concept of dummy variables to use those as predictors of seasonal patterns in a time series. And here I'm going to use the example of electricity demand that we discussed earlier, and we want to account for the day of the week as a predictor in our regression analysis. Electricity demand can change depending on the day of the week, as we discussed earlier. So here we want to include the effect of the day of the week on electricity demand. To model the day of the week, what we can do is we can create dummy variables in our regression model, and these dummy variables will take the value of 0 or 1. For example, in this case, we have the day of the week in our data starting from Monday. We have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and so on. For the very first day of the week, we are going to ask the question whether this day is Monday. So our question will be whether this day is Monday. And for the first observation, yes, the day is Monday, so we'll write down 1 for this observation. For the second day, we are going to ask the same question, whether this day is Monday, and our answer is no, this day is Tuesday. Hence, we're going to code it as 0. Similarly, we're going to do it for every observation and write down zeros whenever the day is not a Monday, and 1 when the day is Monday. And then we are going to create another dummy variable if the day is Tuesday. We're going to code this dummy variable equals 1 for the Tuesdays and 0 otherwise. Similarly, we're going to create 6 dummy variables depending on the day of the week, and we will have a data like this, and then we have a couple of other observations in our data set. For example, electricity demand and some other variables on the right hand side. This is the way that we can code these dummy variables. In the next stage, all we have to do is we have to write down our model as electricity demand, and we are going to write down beta 0 plus beta 1 d1 up to beta 6 d6, and we can also include some other variables, xt variables, in this equation. And these xt variables will capture the effect of other variables on electricity demand. Now these dummy variables will capture the effect of that day on the electricity demand. Notice that we have 6 dummy variables for 7 categories here, and the category that we omitted here is day Sunday. So we did not create it one category, and we omit that category, and when we will be interpreting the results, we will be interpreting the coefficient values for all these dummy variables in relation to that omitted category. There's also an issue with including all the categories in our regression model, and that issue is called dummy variable trap. Now the interpretation of each dummy variable coefficient will be the effect of that category relative to the omitted category. For example, here we have beta 1, which is Monday. Whatever coefficient value that we will get for beta 1, that beta 1 will measure the effect of Monday relative to Sunday. And remember, here Sunday is our omitted category. For example, if beta 1 is equal to 3, we can interpret this as electricity demand will be higher on Monday as compared with Sunday by 3 units. So this is a way of modeling these seasonal patterns using a dummy variable. In the next video, I'm going to show you an example and talk about the interpretation of these dummy variables. But essentially, the idea here is to code these dummy variables in such a way that they will show the presence or absence of a particular season in our data. And then we're going to model these by omitting one season and interpreting the remaining seasons in comparison with the omitted season. So this is how you can build seasonal dummy variables in your regression model. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.